HACCP tutorial. How to generate test data and dummy files. An interesting use case of HACCP is to generate new files out of nothing. Generating dummy data is particularly useful when you want to handle IT tests, for instance performance tests, and do not want to use real data, or do not have access to such data. Of course, the files you want to generate may require to follow some structure, and content may require to be representative of real data. For this, we will start from an empty screen and directly select the Generate Random Grid option from the File menu. A new dialog will open. On the left side of this dialog you will select options to define the different columns of your random grid. On the right side you will see the list of columns already defined. Below, you will see some sample rows that match your definition. I will not go through all options of the dialog, but will show you now how to define a file with different columns. First, an ID column, which is a unique, incremental integer value. Then, a name column, which will be composed of random first names and last names, in pretty print. These will be my always filled columns. Now let's add some more. A birth date, with a format of my choice. Dates of birth will range from 1930 to 2010. This time, I will have such values for only 50% of the rows. You can see in the sample rows, the new file starting to shape up. Let's add an email, based on random email names and domains. This time, it will mostly be filled, only 10% of rows will not have an email. The next column will be a status, with values we can decide. This will be done with a list of constants we will type in. Let's say that only public, private, not a customer, are valid values. And let's set this one as a always filled column. And let's add another constants based column, preferred color. You can see that predefined lists of constants exist. Like OS, browsers, etc. We will use the colors list of constants. Sometimes the list of constants contain multiple times the same value. This is to influence the random number of occurrences of the value, to not get a linear distribution. For instance, for an ABC distribution, you see more C than A in the list. Let's add this as a customer classification. On a large file, you will see that we will get approximately 80% of C, 15% of B, and 5% of A. When you want to have a big list of constants, instead of typing in the list separated by commas, you can also take the values from an external file. We will not do this here. Let's add some final columns. We will call GUID a universally unique identifier. We will call address, a postal address, generated from a dictionary of random names of streets, in English and French formats. And we will call phone, a phone number. Now that the structure of the file is satisfactory, I could directly generate a grid. However, since I like the definition of this file, I will first save the structure definition, so I could regenerate as many files as I want. Or maybe update and modify this structure definition if it does not exactly fit my needs. Before generating the grid, I can select the number of rows I want. Here we will generate a grid of 100,000 rows. Clicking on Generate New Grid shows nearly instantaneously the result. By looking at the grid information, we can see some details of what was generated. Let's see specifically the customer classification column for instance. You can see that the distribution, on 100,000 rows, match the number of occurrences we selected in the list of constants. I will now go back to the Generate Random Grid dialog, and reopen my structure definition. Now, instead of generating a grid in memory, I could also generate a big file, of millions of rows. This is done through direct file export. There is an option to generate a CSV file of course, but we could also generate a JSON file, which we could then use to test performance of some software solutions that process JSON. A last option we can use, is to add columns to the current grid, instead of generating a brand new one. For instance, let's load our standard, small file. To this file, I will just add dummy columns, that will consist of a numeric sequence identifier, a dummy phone number, and lastly, a monetary value with a currency prefix. By clicking on Generate, Add to Current Grid, you see that only new columns were added to the 1000 rows coming from the file. Of course, don't forget to save the result of your newly generated file if you are happy with it. There are two other ways to generate random grids. The first one is to add random columns without selecting any option. This allows to quickly build up a completely random file, based on a randomly defined structure. The second option is to define the structure based on another file profile. In the video on file profiling and data quality, we did see how to define a file profile and save such a profile. We can generate a random grid based on this profile definition. Profile definition files have the CCN extension, and random grid definition files have the CRN extension. A file built on a profile definition file may not have the same finesse and accuracy as building a file defined on a random grid definition, but may help you get similar files very rapidly. This ends our tutorial on dummy file generation features. I hope you will make Carcep one of your preferred tools.